The midterm elections are just 36 days away, and Democrats are looking with hopeful eyes toward that blessed day, a day they hope will shift the balance of power in the House and particularly in the Senate. The polls don't look great for them in the Senate. They'd have to run the table in order to take that chamber. But if they do, they plan to stymie President Trump's agenda. In particular, they want to stymie his Supreme Court nominees. That task begins with stopping the confirmation of Judge Brett Kavanaugh. For weeks, Democrats have been engaged in delay tactics designed to push off Kavanaugh's confirmation beyond November 6th. It began with Senator Dianne Feinstein, who received a 36-year-old allegation of sexual abuse on July 30th from Christine Blasey Ford, then did nothing about it for weeks upon weeks until it was nearly time to confirm Kavanaugh. Then she suddenly came forward with the allegations, demanding a hearing. Republicans attempted to facilitate one, so Democrats delayed. Meanwhile, Democrats demanded a full FBI investigation, an investigation they hoped would take weeks on end. Well, now, such an FBI investigation is pointless. A non-criminal FBI investigation actually has less power to compel testimony than the Senate Judiciary Committee. The FBI can't subpoena records or force people to testify. The FBI doesn't come to findings on allegations. They merely compile statements, the same statements already given under penalty of perjury by witnesses who don't actually back Ford's account. If those witnesses change their testimony now, they may be perjuring themselves. An FBI investigation was completely superfluous. It was a transparent attempt to waste time. But all Democrats had to do was peel off one sucker among the Republicans. Enter Senator Jeff Flake. On Friday, despite already having stated he would support Kavanaugh's nomination in the absence of any corroborating evidence from Ford, Flake collapsed. So why did Flake collapse? Because some protesters screamed at him in an elevator. I'm not kidding. At all.
You're telling me that my assault doesn't matter, that what happened to me doesn't matter, and that you're gonna let people who do these things into power? That's what you're telling me when you vote for him.
Well, that's not actually what Jeff Flake was telling her. In fact, what Jeff Flake was telling her was that there was no corroborative evidence about the allegations. But according to Western Journal, one of the women yelling at Flake is a professional activist with a leftist organization to which George Soros donates. So there's that. But with the courage of his convictions, Jeff Flake demanded a week-long FBI investigation. It didn't help him with the left, by the way. Yesterday, he appeared in an event with Democratic Senator Chris Coons and received a less than pleasant response.
So keep reaching out, because we hear you and we need to keep hearing from you.
So feel free to join me in an elevator anytime.
Oh, the sweet sounds of bipartisanship. So, will the FBI investigation satisfy people who oppose Kavanaugh? Of course not. It's all about the stall. Just like clockwork, Ford's lawyer said the investigation shouldn't have any timeline or any restrictions. This will be the talking point from Democrats all week, and we can surely expect more uncorroborated allegations to be brought forward by Democrats. After all, they've spent the last 2 weeks humoring allegations up to and including gang rape. Now, all this may sound cynical to you, but there is literally nothing to which senatorial Democrats will not stoop to stop Brett Kavanaugh. Nothing. Their behavior this week has been nothing less than despicable. Democratic senators asked Kavanaugh whether he was a gang rapist. They suggested that because he drank in high school, he was an attempted rapist, which would make like 85% of the American populace possible rapists. They even asked him questions about his high school yearbook.
Have you, I don't know if it's buffed or boofed, how do you pronounce that?
That refers to flatulence. We were 16.
Okay. And so when your friend Mark Judge said the same, put the same thing in his yearbook page back to you, he had the same meaning. It was flatulence.
I don't know what he did, but that's my recollection. We want to talk about flatulence at age 16 on a yearbook page. I'm game.
These are very, very serious people. Then, when Kavanaugh got angry, Democrats said that his anger was evidence that he could rape women. Seriously. Here is former Democratic Senator Barbara Boxer from my home state of California.
All of a sudden, we see a man transformed from a choir boy who, up to now, has said, after hours in front of the committee, he lived this very perfect life. All of a sudden, his anger is triggered. And what we saw today is someone who you could now see attacking a woman.
This is insane. It's disgusting. And it really is nothing less than a witch hunt. If Kavanaugh wasn't angry at being called a rapist, that would probably mean he was a rapist, according to the left. If he got angry, that would also probably mean that he was a rapist. But Senator Feinstein, who manipulated the entire process and facilitated claims that Kavanaugh is a rapist, and then, to complete the circus, invited charmed actress Alyssa Milano to sit behind Kavanaugh and scowl during his testimony. This is the mark of a very, very serious senator, of course. She now says that Brett Kavanaugh is unfit for the high court because he didn't treat her with the proper respect.
This was not someone who reflected an impartial temperament or the fairness and even-handedness one would see in a judge. This was someone who was aggressive and belligerent. I have never seen someone who wants to be elevated to the highest court in our country behave in that manner.
I agree with Senator Feinstein. Kavanaugh didn't show the proper respect for Feinstein and her Democratic colleagues. The proper amount of respect was none. No respect. Democrats have earned no respect. They deserve no respect. They have lied and they have slandered Brett Kavanaugh for weeks. And it's not just the Democratic members of the Senate. It's the leftist members of the mainstream media who have unleashed full-scale sexist and indeed racist attacks in order to prevent Kavanaugh's nomination. On Saturday, Maureen Dowd of the New York Times wrote that Kavanaugh's passionate self-defense was just another example of, quote, entitled white men acting like the new minority, howling about things that are being taken away from them, aggrieved at anything that diminishes them or saps their power. Kavanaugh is howling because Democrats have tried to strip him of his basic American rights, the presumption of innocence and due process, to suggest, as Maureen Dowd does, that white men are not entitled to such rights because they're members of a disfavored group. We have a word for that. It's called sexism and racism. Yet that has become a key Democratic talking point in the past few weeks. Accused people have rights unless they hold the wrong political perspective. And if those accused men like Brett Kavanaugh are angry at false accusations, that's just evidence of their misogyny, in the words of University of Chicago professor Martha Nussbaum in Saturday's Washington Post. Kavanaugh isn't a man defending his reputation, his livelihood, and his family. He's just a mean male motivated by, quote, fear-driven rage. The left is willing to tear away the veneer of civilization in order to achieve Brett Kavanaugh's defeat. Even the ACLU, a group supposedly dedicated to protecting the rights of the accused, a group that doesn't even take positions on judicial nominees, broke its long-standing policy this weekend thanks to the allegations against Kavanaugh. Yep, you heard that right. An organization that has spent decades defending people accused of crimes against due process violations now says Brett Kavanaugh should be kept off the Supreme Court without any corroborative evidence of a 36-year-old allegation. So, will the bet pay off for Democrats? Who knows? Maybe Republicans will stand up a week from now. Maybe Kavanaugh will still sit on the court. But one thing is for certain. Democrats, who sold their soul to maintain federally protected abortion on the Supreme Court, cannot be trusted with power. If Democrats take the Senate, more than the Supreme Court is at stake. If they can ruin Brett Kavanaugh by running roughshod over his rights, what do you think they'll do to your rights? Show up to vote on November 6th.